Welcome to the MEP Academy. We're going to cover the requirements for condensate drain piping and design. The proper sizing and layout of condensate drain lines is important for the protection of property and for the proper functioning of the air conditioning equipment. Condensate drain pipe sizing is dictated by the local code. Enclosed, you will find the requirements for many local codes. But be sure to check your local code for the requirements. If the outlet size of the equipment condensate drain is larger than what is shown in this chart, then you'll be required to use the larger outlet size. As you can see, the chart is indicated by the tons of refrigeration, so the air conditioning tons. So up to 20 tons, you can use a 3/4 inch, 21 to 40 tons, a 1 inch, and so on. As you accumulate more tonnage tied into your main condensate pipe, you will increase the size. And then the pipe needs to be sloped 1/8 inch per foot or 1%. So that's 1/8 inch every 12 inches to make sure that that condensate keeps moving. Now, if you have an air conditioning unit or an evaporator coil above a hard lid ceiling, inaccessible ceiling, or located in the attic space, then you'll need to provide some means for protecting the building elements from the overflow of the primary drain or for indicating that there is a leak. Also, drain pans that are poorly drained can cause water to stay in the pan, risking the possibility of algae and bacteria growth. So you want to make sure the water moves out of the pan and keeps moving. So below are some of the possible solutions, but always ask your local code for the approved method. The first option would be to have a secondary drain pan with the drain piping going to a observable area. That can be, you'd want it to drip in front of a window or in a doorway so that the occupants would know that the primary drain is clogged and is overflowed into the secondary drain pan, which would immediately start to drip in some observable area. So that's option one. Option two, you can just use a secondary drain pipe on the primary drain, locating that secondary drain pipe above the primary drain location below the lip of the top of the drain pan. And once again, you would locate that secondary drain piping to drip or to terminate in an observable location. So if the primary drain got clogged, then it would indicate to the tenants of such condition. Option three would be that you would use a leak detection device in your primary drain above the location of where the primary drain piping connection is. So once the primary drain clogs, the primary drain will start to fill up with water, and then it will hit this leak detection device before it gets to the top, very top of the drain pan. And that leak detection device will shut the air conditioner down, and that prevents water from overflowing the pan. Now, the fourth way, option number four, is similar. You'll put a secondary drain pan with a leak detection device on the bottom of the pan. So if the primary pan overflows and starts to leak into the secondary pan, the secondary pan will catch it, and the leak detection device will shut off the air conditioner from running any further. On that secondary drain pan, there is no secondary drain piping. You're using the leak detection device as a protection method to shut down the unit. So additional drain pan and drain pan connections shall be provided with a drain pipe that will terminate, remember, in an observable area as shown in this picture here, but of course you wouldn't have the pipe sticking down that would be visible. You would terminate the end of that pipe flush with the ceiling, so it's not observable, but the water dripping would be observable. So drain terminations. So on your primary drain terminations, you have some options where you can terminate them. And indirect drains, if you have a condensate pump, you can pump that to an indirect drain. You can terminate in dry wells, leach pits, landscaped areas that are properly designed to handle the volume of condensate, and to properly design stormwater treatment systems. Now you have to check with your local code to see which one of these is acceptable in your area. So if you go to an indirect drain, the choices are a lavatory tailpiece in the same tenant space as the air conditioner. So if you're going to tie into a tailpiece, it needs to be in the same location, the same tenant as the air conditioning cooling coil. You can go to a laundry standpipe, janitor sink, inlet of bathtub overflow, but it must be accessible. Or in some codes, in some jurisdictions, because of water conservation, they want you to collect the condensate and send it to the cooling tower. So they want you to recirculate that back to the tower. But check your local code. So here's an image of a connection to a tailpiece for a plumbing fixture. But remember, it has to be in the same space as the air conditioning coil. Now a dry well, if approved in your area, can have various requirements. Check your local code once again. Some of the requirements can be a minimum size hole, such as 2 foot by 2 foot by 3 foot deep, or it could be a round hole, such as a 12 inch diameter by 3 feet deep. So the depth and the size of the hole will be dictated by code and whether or not you can use a pipe, round pipe, as your dry well. Minimum of 6 inches of soil or concrete shall be provided as cover above the rocks that are put within the dry well. Usually the rocks are minimum size of 1 inch diameter, gravel or crushed rocks that will fill the dry well. The termination of the condensate pipe shall connect indirectly to the dry well drain pipe, and the dry well drain pipe has to be a minimum of 1.5 inches PVC or approved material. And the dry well should be kept at least 3 feet away from the building structure or any footings, because what's going to happen, the point of the dry well is to put the water, the condensate, back into the soil. So another water conservation method. As you can see here, this is 1.5 inch pipe going to a dry well that's 24 inches deep and 12 inches to the top of it from the ground level. Now, some locations where you can't terminate condensate. Public ways like sidewalks, driveways, alleys. You cannot terminate your condensate into these areas. Now, excluded from code requirements, excluded from these codes are non-condensing type of equipment like radiant cooling panels. They're designed to prevent condensate from occurring by keeping the temperature of the chilled water above the dew point temperature or vapor pressure of the surrounding air. These systems are designed to operate in sensible cooling only modes, so you shouldn't have any condensate, so they're excluded. Now, the piping materials allowed are usually, you'll find copper, PVC DWV, CPVC, ABS DWV, polyethylene, galvanized steel, cast iron. Also, the use of short radius elbows are often prohibited. You can normally use standard fittings until you reach a certain size, at which point you may be required to use the drainage pattern fittings, the DWV type. Traps. Traps are to be installed as required per the manufacturer's recommendation. So no traps are required on a secondary drain pan. This is to allow immediate notification that the primary drain has failed, so no traps on the secondary drain pipe. Cleanouts are required in case of plugged drain pipes, so provide is required to prevent the need to cut the drain pipe for unplugging. Some of the following may be used for cleanouts if approved by your local authority. Plug tees, union connections, short clamped hoses at the unit, as in an indirect connection to the tailpiece of the plumbing fixture. So when you have more than one air conditioning unit condensate tied to a main condensate pipe, then every change of direction shall have some method of cleanout. Condensate pumps can be used to elevate the condensate vertically to a point where it will then discharge to a code-approved gravity sloping condensate drain line. The condensate pump should be interlocked with the air conditioning unit to prevent the operation of the air conditioning unit if the condensate pump is inoperable. Please remember that code requirements are always changing, so check for the most current code in your area at the time of design and installation, or ask an inspector for the current installation practice. Please subscribe to our videos, and we look forward to the next one.